getting shared with me. Just a second. सदाशिव समारंभाम शंकराचार्य मध्यमाम अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंताम वंदे गुरु परंपराम श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानाम आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवत् व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः यो ब्रह्माणमिदाति पूर्वं यो वेदाश्च प्रेणोति तस्मै तगुम्हदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुरो ये शरणमहं प्रपद्ये ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः श्रीचिद्घनगणेशाय नमो मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपयो अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धेदृक्यत्व निर्मलोपारं सर्ववेदान्त वेद्यं प्रत्येक परं महः तदेवाहन्नमत्वन्यति मे निश्चितामतिः। सो कंटिन्यूइंग विथ हूज ईश्वरः, ईश्वरः इज सर्वज्ञः एंड नित्यमुक्तः। सो तस्माद् ईश्वरः नित्य मुक्त सर्वज्ञश्च भवति। दिस वाज एक्सप्लेन्ड इन यस्टरडेज पार्ट। एंड देन जीवेश्वरयोः अधिष्ठानभूतं शुद्ध चैतन्यं बंधमोक्षादि निखिल भेद शून्यं सदा आकाशवद एकरस स्वभावं तयोः उभयोरपि वर्तते। Jiva has been defined, Ishvara has been defined. The Adhisthana Chaitanya for Jiva called as Kutastha, and Shuddha Chaitanya, which is the Adhisthana for Ishvara, they are same. There's only Nama Bheda. So Jiveshwara Adhisthana Bhutam Shuddha Chaitanya, the Shuddha Chaitanya which is called as Brahma and Kutastha, that Chaitanya, Bandha Mokshadi Nikila Bheda Shunya, it has nothing to do with the Bandha or Moksha. Bandha is Mithya, Moksha is Mithya. Only Brahma is Sat. Therefore, that Shuddha Chaitanya has nothing to do with Bandha Moksha Adipadena Shrishti Ityadi, Shrishti Stiti Laya also. Entire Vyavastha does not have anything to do with Shuddha Chaitanya because everything is Mithya other than Shuddha Chaitanya Brahma. Sada Akashavad Ekarasa Swabhavam. It is always single homogeneous entity which has never segmented in any dasha, any avastha. Tayoho Ubhayorapi Vartate. Whether it is from the perspective of Jiva or Ishvara, the Shuddha Chaitanya is Nirvikari. बंधमोक्षादिस्तु आभासांशेव चिदाभासा विच वेरीज बेस्ड ऑन द रिफ्लेक्टिंग मीडियम बेस्ड ऑन वेदर द उपाधि इज अविद्या और माया बेस्ड ऑन दैट द अंश वेरीज द अंश इज ईदर स्मॉल और इट इज बिग अ ह्यूज अंश और अ स्मॉल अंश द व्यष्टि अंश और द समष्टि अंश सो इफ द व्यष्टि अंश has Chidabhasa and Samashti Amsha also has Chidabhasa, there is a difference in Chidabhasa. Chit does not vary, but Chidabhasa varies because of the reflecting medium. How so? If the original Bimba is same, how can the Pratibimba be different? We can understand through Pratibimba. Of course, Abhasa can be anything. That way also you can see, but in Pratibimba you can clearly see if the mirror is colored or mirror is concave, it's convex, it can make you look elongated, it can make look you stout, it can bring in any kind of variation. So based on the upadhi of darpana, the bimba appears differently. Same bimba appears differently in different darpanas. So the pratibimba varies. Similarly, based on the vyashti upadhi and samashti upadhi, avidya and maya, chidabhasa varies. So bandha mokshadistu abhasa unsheva. Now which abhasa? Which chidabhasa? Bandhamoksha is not there for Ishvara. Adishthane chaitanye tu abhasasya bhrantya pratiyate. So hold on to that thought. He is going to mention that later. Which abhasa has bandhamoksha? Adishthane chaitanye tu abhasasya bhrantya eva pratiyate. Bandhamoksha. So bandhamoksha pratiti is there in adishthana chaitanya. I feel that I, pratyagatma, whose real meaning is kutastha chaitanya, I do not know that and I think that I am a samsari. I have bandha and moksha. I have bandha, I have to struggle for moksha. All these are bhrantis. Tasmat kevala abhasa eva bandha mokshadi vyavaharaha. Bandha moksha vyavahara is only possible for chidabhasa. Tatra api asti etavan bhedaha. There is a difference between the chidabhasas also. Yasminna abhase swarupavarnam asti tasminneva bandha. Although Ishvara has chidabhasa, in the sense Ishvara has three components, we identify the difference by upadhi and the chidabhasa. Chidabhasa will also vary because of upadhi being different. Because Brahma Chaitanya is common. Kutastha Chaitanya and Brahma Chaitanya are same. We think that the reflection also should be same. Chidabhasa or Pratibimba should be same. But since the upadhi is different, it will create a variation in the combination whereby chidabhasa will also vary. So yasmin nabhase, yasmin chidabhase, swarupavaranam asti, where there is swarupavaranam. One who knows that pratibimba and bimba are same, does not have avarana at all. So one who thinks that pratibimba is different becomes a samsari. So here, yasmin nabhase chidabhase swarupa avaranam asti. One who does not know one's swarupa because the avarana is there. Avidya creates an avarana at the vyashti level. Maya causes vikshepa at the samashti level. That is the prapancha. Called as avidya shakti also. But maya shakti makes it more clear because we don't think that the individual is a creator. Although there is no difference between the individual and the total. However, Ishvara is not lost on his tattva. His reality is not lost on him. So, Maya, Avarana Shakti does not veil his understanding. He is ever Nitya Mukta. Why? Because Avarana Shakti is not working. Vikshepa is his own Shakti that he wields. So Chidabhasa at the individual level, Vyashti level, has Avarana. So Swarupa Avarana is there. Thereby Tasminneva Bandha, Tasminneva Jiva Chidabhase Bandha. Yatra Tannasti Satu Mukta Eva. So Ishvara is Mukta because he does not have Avarana. Ishvare Avarana Abhavadeva Sanitya Mukta. Ishvara does not have Avarana, therefore is Nitya Mukta. Similarly, Jnani, whose Avarana goes away by Ajnana going away due to Jnana, Vikshepa may be there, but still Avarana not being there, he is Mukta. Jivetu Avarana Sattvat Sabaddha. Jivaha Baddha because Avarana is continuing to exist. Yato Yasya Avidyaya Aumshe Pratibimbitasya Chidabhasasya Jivatvam Bhavati Tasya Avidyaya Avarakatvam Svabhavaha. Yataha, since Yasya Avidyaya Aumshe, in whichever Aumsha ऑफ अविद्या देर इज प्रतिबिंब प्रतिबिंबित चिदाभास जीवत्व दैट प्रतिबिंब प्रतिबिंबित रिफ्लेक्टेड चिदाभास हैज जीवत्व जीवत्व भाव इज देर आई एम अ जीव बिकॉज देर इज अविद्या कंटिन्यूइंग एंड इन द पार्ट ऑफ दैट अविद्या when you have a bimba and pratibimba darpana is darpana can be small then the entire darpana has the pratibimba but if there is a huge darpana bigger than the size of our body then when you look at the darpana only a ansha of darpana is having the pratibimba Whereas the rest, mean pratibimba in a sense, everything, there is a pratibimba of everything. But still, when I'm looking at myself, only my body being reflected in a huge mirror, the other parts are not reflecting me. So compared to me as bimba, the pratibimba is smaller in size, ansha. Only in the darpana ansha ye pratibimba bhavati. Mama pratibimba. Mama bimba rupasya, mama Pratibimba bhavati. The rest is not reflecting me at least. And that much is the example. We do not need to compare the other part of the mirror. So considering that example, yato yasyaha avidyayaha aunshe pratibimbitasya chidabhasasya jivattvam bhavati tasya avidyayaha avarakattvam svabhavaha. So whichever part of avidya reflects a chidabhasa and that chidabhasa has jivatva bhava combination of the three of course tasya avidyaya avarakattvam svabhava only that particular avidya is going to have avarana it will veil the person यद्यपि एकस्येव वस्तुनः माया अज्ञानम् अविद्या इत्यादि नामानि तथापि तस्येव शुद्धसत्त्व गुणप्रधानत्वात् माया इति मलिनसत्त्व गुणप्रधानत्वात् च अज्ञानम् अविद्या इति च व्यवहारः व्हाई इज ही टॉकिंग अबाउट अंशा बिकॉज अविद्या इज नॉट अविद्याज आर नॉट मेनी अविद्या इज वन Bhamatikara talks about multiple avidyas, but in Vivarana Sampradaya, there is only one avidya called as Maya or Ajnana. It is the same thing. Therefore, there is an Aumsha, each and every Aumsha claims Pratibimba and then also claims Jivatva, Jivabhava. When that happens, then that particular avidya Aumsha is responsible for veiling. Of course, there is veiling, jivatvam, and it is explained by, since there is jivatvam, you have to infer there is veiling. Jivatvam cannot precede avarana. If you have to think about jivatva bhava is there, then avarana has to be there. Without avarana, there cannot be jivatva bhava. At least in that duration of time. The rest of the avidya need not be having the avarna swabhava. So it can be explained with aunshas of one single maya or avidya. Thereby, yadyapi ekasyeva vastunaha maya, ajnanam, avidya ityadi namani. Although a single entity is called as maya, ajnana, avidya, tamas also sometimes, ityadi. So tamas also, tamaha. तथापि इवन देन इवन सो तस्येव शुद्ध सत्व गुण प्रधानत्वात् बट स्टिल इफ शुद्ध सत्व गुण प्रधान अंश इज टेकन दैट इज कॉल्ड एज माया एंड मलिन सत्व गुण प्रधान इज कॉल्ड एज अज्ञान अविद्या इति च व्यवहार दिस वी हैव सीन इन द लास्ट पार्ट आल्सो रजस्तमो गुणाभ्याम अभिभूत सत्व गुणो मलिन सत्व गुण इत्युच्यते व्हाट इज मलिन सत्व Malina sattva called as avidya for jiva is because raja and tama are overshadowing sattva guna. They overpower sattva guna. Therefore, jnana is not possible. Avarana continues. Then one takes the vikshepa to be real and remains a samsari. This is the vyavastha. Rajastamo gunadikya deva avidya svapratibimbita jiva rupa chidabhasa amshasya avaranam karoti. Because rajas and tamas continue to be there in abundance, therefore what happens that avidya creates an avarana for whom svapratibimbita jiva rupa chidabhasa amshasya. It creates avarana for the chidabhasa amsha in the jiva rupa. So jiva rupa chidabhasa amsha has the avarana. Then one cannot know that it is the pratibimba me who is fake, because I am not different from the bimba chaitanya. Svapratibimba. Svapratibimbita. It is one's own real self which is reflecting. We hold on to the reflection, not the real self, due to avarana, and that is because of rajas and tamas being in abundance. That is why entire sadhana is to improve the sattva, sattva guna. Once sattva guna comes to forefront, then what will happen is that it should remain in such a powerful measure that it counters the rajas and tamas. And then one can have jnana, which will lead to sukha. Ata eva jivaha baddha na ishwaraha. So jivaha baddha na ishwara means ishwara baddha na bhavati. Jiva eva baddha bhavati. So jiva na ishwara, that may also work. But here baddha is predicated. So jivaha baddha bhavati, ishwara baddha na bhavati. This is the reasoning. Because of rajas tamas leading to malina sattvam of ajnana, that causes avarana, and jiva continues as a samsari, baddha jiva, whereas ishwara does not have avarana. Why? Because of sattva, shuddha sattva guna. It is not mixed up with rajas and tamas. That kind of maya is his upadhi. Sarvadhisthana bhuta shuddha chaitanya sahitaha maya pratibimbita chidabhasa rupa ishwaraha. Who is that ishwara? Tatpada vachyartaha. In tattvamasi, the meaning of tatpada, literal meaning, is ishwara, who is chidabhasa pratibimbita in maya, who is along with shuddha chaitanya, which is the adhisthana for everything. Sarvadhisthana bhuta shuddha chaitanya sahita maya pratibimbita chidabhasa rupa ishwara is tatpada vachyartha. What is the lakshyartha then? Kevala adhisthana shuddha chaitanyam tatpada lakshyartha. Lakshyartha, however, the implied meaning is kevala adhisthana shuddha chaitanya. Shuddha chaitanya, which is just the adhisthana, it has nothing to do with anything that is adhyarupita. Does not have anything to do with the adhyastha, prapancha, or even ishwaratvam really. Ishwaraha jagad utpatti stiti samaharan karoti iti shastroktehe ayam abhiprayaha. When the shastra says that Ishwara creates, sustains and destroys the prapancha, or manifests and unmanifests the prapancha at the beginning of the kalpa, at the end of the kalpa, and sustains in between, what is the idea there? Adhisthana bhuta shuddha chaitanya akashavad asangam. There adhisthana chaitanya always remains free from the creatorship also, ishwaratvam also. Like akasha, it is asangam. Maya pratibimbita chidabhasamshaha jagad utpatyadikam karoti. However, the upadhi that has created this pratibimba called as chidabhasa, that amsha, that part of the Ishwara in the triad, is responsible for jagad utpatti ityadi. सर्वज्ञत्वादि गुणोपि तस्यैव. व्हेन यू से ईश्वर इज सर्वज्ञ, दैट टाइम ब्रह्म कैनॉट बी सर्वज्ञ. ब्रह्म इज नॉट सर्वज्ञ. निर्गुण ब्रह्म कैनॉट बी हैव सर्वज्ञत्वम ऑल्सो एज इट्स ओन गुण धर्म बिकॉज इट बिकॉज ऑफ बीइंग निर्गुण निर्गुणत्वात्. सो सर्वज्ञत्व इज ऑल्सो एट द ईश्वराज लेवल, नॉट एट सगुण लेवल, नॉट एट निर्गुण लेवल. भक्तानुग्रहादि कर्तृत्वम ऐश्वर्यांतरम अपि तस्येव चिदाभास अंशस्य, चिदाभास अंशस्य. अगेन दैट चिदाभास अलोन विच इज सगुणत्वम देयर ब्रिंगिंग सगुणत्वम इज द रियल ईश्वर एंड एनी अदर ऐश्वर्य शक्ति दैट यू टॉक अबाउट. इच्छा शक्ति, क्रिया शक्ति, ज्ञान शक्ति, ऑल दैट and anugraha for bhakta ityadi, blessing the you know devotees, giving darshana, taking avatara, all that is chidabhasa amshasya eva gunaha natu shuddha chaitanyasya. Chaitanya swarupam tu ekarasam sarvasamam, that chaitanya however remains one, ever one, never segmented across ishwar and jiva both. तस्मिन् सत्तास्फूर्ति प्रदत्तमंतरा अन्यद् ऐश्वर्यादिकं न किञ्चिदपि उपपद्यते इति. सो तस्मिन् तस्मिन् सर्वसमे एकरसे चैतन्य स्वरूपे ब्रह्मणि सत्तास्फूर्ति प्रदत्तमंतरा, अदर देन लेंडिंग सत्ता एंड स्फूर्ति, सत्ता बिकॉज ऑफ सत्स्वरूप एंड स्फूर्ति बिकॉज ऑफ चित् स्वरूप, अन्य ऐश्वर्यादिकं न किञ्चिदपि उपपद्यत उपपद्यते इति. सो उपपद्यत इति, देयर इज नो अदर ऐश्वर्य इत्यादि गुणास पॉसिबल, नॉट इवन अ लिटिल. एंड हाउ इज सत्तास्फूर्ति ऑल्सो, सो देयर टिप्पणा देयर, सत्तास्फूर्ति ऑल्सो सत्तास्फूर्ति प्रदत्वम स्थितिभान प्रदत्वम, जस्ट लेंडिंग satta meaning there is something, sthiti, there is something out there, whatever it is, whether it is avidya, maya, the sukshma sharira, stula sharira, all the vishayas, the entire prapancha, do you say it is there, sthita, there is a sthiti, it is there, then that is due to brahma, brahma lending without actually lending on its own, there is no kartrutva there, just by mere presence lends the sthiti. Why? It is its swarupa, swabhava, it is its swabhava. And bhana, asti and bhati, so kinchid api asti kinchid bhati, idam asti idam bhati jagat, including your own sharira, shariratraya, it is there and there is a pratiti. They go together, asti bhati. Sometimes asti, something is there like rajju, but sarpa, sarpavad bhati, but still something else bhati is there. So asti bhati go together. When you say asti, something is there, it may not appear the way it is, that is samsara, that is pratibhasa, but satta spurti, wherever it is, whether it is right or wrong, all that is provided by Brahma Chaitanya, one's own Swarupa. So that is the Ishwara Swarupa Varnana. Before we move on to Brahma Swarupa Varnana, let's go and catch up with Ishwara, explanation of Ishwara in other darshanas, which is given in the Tippana. सो ईश्वर स्वरूपम तु बहुधा अनेकैः वर्ण्यते. वेरियस दर्शनास टॉक अबाउट इट इन वेरियस वेज, एंड अदर देन दर्शनास आल्सो देयर आर यू नो यू कैन से दर्शनास, बट अदर यू नो अदर फिलोसोफर्स और विदाउट हैविंग फिलोसॉफी आल्सो रियली बेस्ड ऑन सम धर्म ग्रंथ समथिंग एल्स दे विल हैव कंक्लूडेड समथिंग. सो देयर आर वेरियस व्यूज About Ishwara, what is the Ishwara Swarupa? Tatahi योग मतानुसारेण सारिणः तु एवं आहुः. सो दोज़ हू फॉलो योग मत योग दर्शन व्हाट डू दे से चैतन्य समीपस्थ प्रकृति प्रेरकः जीव विलक्षण पुरुष ईश्वरः. चैतन्य समीपस्थ हू इज वेरी नियर टू चैतन्य प्रकृति प्रेरकः हू प्रॉड्स द प्रकृति टू एक्ट who is different from jiva do jiva vilakshanaha purushaha there is a purusha is a special purusha there are many purushas in fact actually yoga is the practice of sankhya sankhya also there are two types one is saishvara sankhya one is nirishvara sankhya generally people think that sankhya does not have ishvara but there is one part of sankhya one division of sankhya where they agree with ishvara there is an ishvara anyway mostly it is sankhya is the sankhya darshana is recreated through karikas which have been translated from another language which has its origin in sanskrita which is lost originally is lost so we don't know really whether the sankhya sutras are perfectly the way they were created we do not know that is why sankhya some parts of sankhyas are not clear like what is the role of ishvara whether it is there or not there ishvara is there or not is not clear there are divisions those who have studied more they may know so yoga mato anusarenah tu evamahu ishvara swarupam what about ishvara swarupa dese chaitanya samipastha prakriti preraka jiva vilakshana purusha ishvarah sacha ishvarah klesha karma tatphala adibhi aspam sanspushtah जीववत असंग चिन्मात्र जीववत ईश्वर इज जीववत बट जीव विलक्षण पुरुष असंग एंड चिन्मात्र दैट इज द जीव स्वरूप आल्सो रियल जीव स्वरूप इज व्हाट असंग जीव पुरुष इज चिन्मात्र हैज नथिंग टू डू विद द प्रधान रियली डज नॉट इवन कनेक्ट विद प्रधान प्रधान क्रिएट्स जड़ा बट क्रिएट्स ईश्वर हैज नो सच रोल टू प्ले Ishvara is like Jiva, Asanga and Chinmatra. However, what is the difference between Jiva and Ishvara? Jiva has Pancha Klesha. Yoga Sutra says, Klesha, Panchatavya, Klishta, Klishtaha, all these Yoga Sutras explain. So there are Kleshas. Jiva is affected by klesha. Klesha, karma, tatphala. So klesha is there. There is karma. Then karma phala also. Due to all of these, he is a samsari. Because he is this jiva has samsparsha with klesha, karma and tatphala. Whereas Ishvara does not have asamsprushtaha. He is not associated with klesha karma and its phala so we also say the same thing ishvara is not affected by karma phala ityadi klesha ityadi we also agree and asanga and chinmatra we also say that what is the difference jiva vilakshanah jiva vilakshana purusha we do not agree with that part thereby they have dvaita they have भिन्न भिन्न पुरुषास एट दी व्यष्टि एंड समष्टि लेवल्स एंड इवन इन व्यष्टि एंड व्यष्टि देयर इज अ डिफरेंस वी डू नॉट एग्री विद एनी ऑफ दी भेदास व्हाटसोएवर जीवस्यापि क्लेशाद्यभावे अपि अविवेकवशात् तत्सत्त्वं प्रतीयते ऑल्दो जीव आल्सो रियली इज असंग एंड चिन्मात्र देयर इज नो क्लेश इत्यादि कर्म कर्तत्वल स्टिल अविवेकवशात् ज्ञान इज एंड देयर Therefore, person does not have viveka, and thereby what happens? Tat sattvam pratiyate appears as though I have klesha. So they do say that klesha ityadi are bhranti, which is the Vedanta siddhanta. But they say the jiva and ishvara bhedas are real. They agree with only the samsarittvam as bhranti. The jagat is real, but the kleshadi is a bhranti because my swarupa is sharira bhinna. Ayam eva jiveshwarayor bheda hetuhu. So this is the difference. Kleshadi being there or not being there is the difference between Ishvara and Jiva. Nyayamata anusarinastu, the Nayayikas, they say asangasya Ishvarasya niyamakatva sambhavat yogamatam akshipya. They make an akshep on yogamata. They say Ishvara cannot be niyamaka if he is asanga. But Ishvara is niyamaka. How can you say Ishvara is niyamaka and asanga? If he has no sangha, how will he be a niyantra? He cannot be niyantra. Therefore, they say Ishvarasya jnana ichha prayatna adi guna nityaha. This jnana ichha prayatna, all these are nitya gunas of Ishvara. He is not asanga. He has sangha. He has sangha by having jnana, ichha, prayatna, ityadi. Thereby, he can be a niyanta. Ato jivad vilakshana bhinna cha ishvara ityahuhu. They say he has these gunas and then he is still different from jiva. That much they agree with yoga shastra. Ishvara is jiva vilakshana. Hiranyagarbha Upasakastu, Hiranyagarbha Upasakas, what do they say? Ishvara Jnanadinam Nityatve Sokamayata Ityadi Shruti Vakyanam Shrutyarambha Samaye Ishvara Jnanadinam Utpatti Pratipadakanam Virodasyat. They say Nayayikas are taking Ishvara Jnana Ityadi as Nitya. If the it is Nitya, Jnana is Nitya, if Ishvara Jnana is Nitya, Ishvara's Jnana, not Ishvara Jnana, Ishvara's Jnana, not like Brahma Jnana, not Karmani Shakti, Sambandha Shakti, Ishvara Jnana, Ishvara's Jnana, etc. What are those, etc.? Jnana, Ichha, Prayatna. If they are Nitya, then Sokamayata, Sa Akamayata, says the Taittiriya Upanishad. Ityadi Shruti Vakyanam Shrishti Arambha Samaye Ishvara Jnanadinam Utpatti Pratipadakanam Virodasyat. Then he cannot desire, and if it is, see, if the Ichha is Nitya, Jnana and Ichha is Nitya, then he cannot have an Utpatti of Ichha. At the beginning of the Kalpa, Sa Akamayata Bhausyam Prajayeti. Let me become many. Whatever he gathers and says, okay, let me have this. He recollects the jnana. Once he has ichha, then he starts the srishti arambha. Start the srishti. So, srishti arambha samaye, Ishvara jnana adinam utpatti pratipadakanam virodasyat. Then it will be opposed to shruti, which says that he began the creation by gathering jnana, by having a desire to create. So ichha and prayatna jnana, neither of the, none of these three can be nitya. They come and go at the beginning of the kalpa. So they take such ashray of shruti and say srishti arambha samaye ishvara jnana adinam utpatti pratipadakanam virodasyat sada srishti prasangascha syat. Then what will happen if he has continuous desire, ichha, of what? Bhausyam Prajayeti. Then the srishti will be continuing ever. He'll always have the desire to create. The prayatna will be nitya. Ichha is nitya. Jnana is nitya. He knows how to create. He will always be having srishti. There will be nothing else. Only srishti will continue. And if you bring in other ichha also, that will also continue parallel. Is the srishti continuous? No, the srishti is at the beginning of the kalpa. This is the Hiranyagarbha Upasaka Mata. They say, therefore what? Ataha asangatam nyayamatam. Therefore, they refute the nyayamata, they negate it. It is not acceptable. Hiranyagarbha eva Ishvara. Then what is the fact about Ishvara? Hiranyagarbha is Ishvara. अस्य लिंग शरीर सत्वेपि अविद्या काम कर्माद्य भाव जीव विलक्षण सही इति आचक्षते. दे ऑल्सो से हिरण्यगर्भ हु इज ईश्वर इज जीव विलक्षण डिफरेंट फ्रॉम जीवा बट लिंग शरीर सत्वेपि he is different from jiva. Jiva also has linga sharira, sukshma sharira. Ishvara also has linga sharira, which is sukshma sharira. However, avidya kama karma adhyabhava, he does not have avidya, whereas jiva has avidya. Hiranyagarbha does not have kama. Jiva in his sukshma sharira has kama, manifests kama as raga and dvesha. Therefore, he does karma, whereas Hiranyagarbha does not do any karma ityadi. So karma phala is not possible. Thereby, jiva vilakshanaha hiranyagarbha ishvaraha. Then the virad upasakas say, virad upasakas tu vinastula deham linga deha matra kutra api ananubhutatvat virad purushayava ishvara ityahuhu. They say, I mean, your refutation is right, but your conclusion is wrong. You are starting by saying linga sharira sattve api. Then, Hiranyagarbha has linga sharira, but then you have not concluded based on linga sharira that creation cannot be possible. How can one with a sukshma sharira and lack of stula sharira do anything? Anything can be done only by a person or any entity who has a gross body, because actions are gross. Only mental activity is possible in sukshma sharira. Kayika karma is where you see this prapancha which is created, which is gross prapancha, stula prapancha. It has to be created by a stula sharira van. Therefore, Hiranyagarbha, who is stula sharira rahita, cannot create. Therefore, Virat, who is stula sharira, samashti stula sharira abhimani is Virat, and sukshma samashti sukshma sharira abhimani is Hiranyagarbha, who does not have any stula sharira, vyashti or samashti. Therefore, Hiranyagarbha cannot be the creator ishvara. Therefore, linga deha matrasya stula deham vina kutra api ananubhutatvat. We do not have any anubhava, any jnana like that. We have never seen any stula being created by any sukshma thing or sukshma entity. Without stula sharira, it isn't possible. Therefore, virat purusha eva ishvara ityahu. Next mata is prajapati upasaka mata. Prajapati upasakastu prajakamasantaha पाणिपादादि युक्त प्राकृत शरीरवतः ईश्वरत्वे क्रिम्यादेरपि ईश्वरत्व प्रसंगात्. हिरण्यगर्भ उपासक मतम असंगतम. दे से दि हिरण्यगर्भ मत इज नॉट वैलिड तथा विराड उपासक मतम अपि असंगतम. एंड विराड उपासक मत इज ऑल्सो नॉट वैलिड as to the definition of Ishvara. Why? Because Hiranyagarbha has samashti sukshma sharira, whereas Virad has samashti stula sharira. Thereby what will happen? Prajakamaha santaha pani padadi yukta prakruta shariravataha. They have bodies. Since they have bodies, embodied, they have become embodied now. Ishvaratve, if you take that kind of entity who has either stula sharira or sukshma sharira as Ishvara, then what will happen? Krimi, insects also have body. They have sukshma sharira as well as stula sharira, which is becoming the body of Hiranyagarbha and Virat respectively, because samashti includes vyashti. Each and every vyashti will also, because each vyashti has a part to play in Hiranyagarbha and Virat, you will end up calling that kind of entity, even a krimi, as Ishvara. So, krimyade api Ishvaratva prasangat. So, when you say the whole is, sum of, you know, sum is, sum total is Ishvara, then the parts are included. They are also Ishvara. That is not right. Therefore, Hiranyagarbha Mata as well as Virad Upasaka, Hiranyagarbha Upasaka Mata as well as Virad Upasaka Mata is untenable. Kintu, then who is Ishvara? Kintu, Chaturmukha Brahma Eva Ishvara. Chaturmukha Brahma Eva Ishvara. Brahma. Brahma Eva Ishvara is Brahma here, Pullinga. Chaturmukha, the four-faced Brahma. Lord Brahma is Ishvara. That is Prajapati, who is called as Prajapati. Prajanam Patihi. Chaturmukha Brahma. He is Ishvara. Sa Eva Ishvara iti Prahuhu. Vaishnavastu. Vaishnavas say, who say Vishnu is Ishvara. None other than Vishnu. Therefore, Vishnur Nabhi Kamalotpannatvat Chaturmukhasya Brahmanaha Tat Karani Bhuto Vishnur Eva Ishvara iti Kathayanti. So they take resort to Purana. Who is this Prajapati? Prajapati is Chaturmukha sitting on a Kamala. Where is this Kamala? Kamala, Kamalam. Kamalam is born out of the Nabhi of Vishnu. Therefore, Vishnur Nabhi Kamalotpannatvat, and he is born out of that Kamala, which is born out of the Nabhi of Vishnu. Then Ishvara, your Ishvara has a Karana, who is my Ishvara. Sarva Karana Rahita, Karana is Ishvara. You cannot have Karana for Ishvara. Ishvara is Karana Rahita, whereas your Chaturmukha Brahma is Karana, which is the Kamalam born out of the Nabhi of the lying Vishnu. Therefore, Brahmanaha Tatkarani Bhutaha Vishnu Eva Ishvara iti Kathayanti. They say Vishnu is Ishvara because he is Karana for your Brahma. Shaivastu. Then those who take Shiva as Ishvara, they refute Vaishnavas by saying Shivasya Padanveshane Ashaktatvad Vishnoho Shiva Eva Ishvara iti Vadanti. So there is another Purana Katha where Brahma and Vishnu were fighting. And when they were fighting, there was some, I don't recall the entire story, but then Shiva came in the form of a beam of light. A beam of light which went vertical from top to down. And then he sent both of them to find the end. He sent and they tried to find the end. They tried to find which is this beam of light, Prakasha. That is Padanveshani. I think that's the story, I think. So they tried to look at the, which is the end, meaning the feet. They tried to look out for the end of that beam. They have been searching, but they couldn't find. Therefore, Shivasya Padanveshane Ashaktatvat. They could not find the end, the feet of Shiva. Therefore, they both, Brahma and Vishnu both. But here, Vishnu couldn't find. Therefore, Vishnoho Ashaktatvat. Vishnu fell short of his Shakti. And Ishvara is Sarva Shaktiman. How can Vishnu fall short of something? Therefore, they say Shiva is Ishvara, not Vishnu. Ganapatyupasakaha, Ganapatyaha. What do they say? Oh, Tripura Sura Jayartham Ishvarena Api Upasitaha Ganapatihi Eva Ishvara iti Manyante. They say Shiva, when he was setting out to win over Tripurasura, that time he prayed to Ganesha. Therefore, how can Shiva Ishvara pray to Ganesha? Who is the real Ishvara then? Ganapati is the Ishvara. So, of course, I mean, these are one lines given. These can be flipped upon by another Purana. So, they will have debate, endless debates among themselves. Ganapatyas will be proven as wrong by saying, oh, born of at least Devi. Therefore, Devi is Ishvara. And Shiva gave Ganapati his head, elephant head. Therefore, he is Ishvara. So, this will be a never-ending debate because Puranas are meant for Upasana and Bhakti of the devotees. Does not mean the other is inferior. All forms are forms of Ishvara. And Vaishnavas will can show some Padma Purana or Vishnu Purana and show that Shiva worshipped Vishnu. All these are possible. And all those will refute each other. All of them will refute each other. No one will be able to define Ishvara unless one goes to Shruti. Shruti is the only Pramana. All these Puranas are not Pramana if they are contradictory to Shruti. Then this Bhairava, Bhairala Adyupasakastu, Tantrikas basically. They say Marano Chatana Vashikaranaha Vashikarana Stambanadi Stambanadi Siddhihetu Bhuta Bhairavadi Mantran. They follow mantras, mantrikas and tantrikas. They get siddhis with all these yantra, tantra, mantra. So marana, uchatana, vashikarana, stambana, adi, siddhi, hetu, bhuta, bhairavadi mantra. These bhairavadi mantras lead to siddhis. Which kind of siddhis? Siddhis such as marana. They can, you know, just by mantra shakti, they can hurt or kill others. And then others also. Let's not go into siddhis. Whatever, you know, controlling the others, vashikarana, ityadi. Whatever those are. Therefore, what happens is siddhis, a person who gets siddhis, he gets an aspect of Ishwaratvam. In that aspect, he is Ishwara. If, let's say, if I can cause death to anyone, I can control anyone, then in that part, at least, I am Ishwara. Thereby, they think that you can get Ishwaratvam by these siddhis. Tattat Stotrani. So, okay, there is a slack. Let's try this. So, Tattat Stotrani, meaning these mantras and then Stotra. Tattat Stotrani, Tad Havana Tarpana, Purascharanadi, Pratipadaka, Tantra Granthascha, Pramani Kritya Bhairavadi Devata, Ishwaratvena Varanayanti. So, who is Ishwara? Bhairava Ityadi, Devatas are Ishwaras because they take these Granthas as Pramana, which are those Tantra Ityadi. They tantra granthas reveal these stotras, havana, tarpana, purascharana, ityadi. Of these mantras, they reveal, stotras they reveal. Thereby, those bhairavadi devatas who lead to siddhis and make us feel like Ishwara in particular aspects, they are Ishwaras. So almost all have been covered. Others are included in on the sidelines at least, if not within. Ittham anantam anantamatani. Ittham anantamatani swasvam mati vilasitani paraspara vilakshanani anyonya viruddhani cha upalabhyante. So you see many matas who elaborate their own mata and refute the others mutually. They will destroy each other. They will not let anyone progress because they will keep on debating with each other. They both are refuted. I mean, all pakshas are refuted by each other because they are all superficial. They don't go to the core, which is within, which is the underlying principle that makes all of these possible. Sakala mata virodhena etad granthokta ishvara swarupam eva shrutya vipretam. Same Ishwara, same Tattva appears as Ishwara in many forms. So all those are Ishwaras, but Ishwara is not limited to any of those. Ishwara is not limited to be Hiranyagarbha, Brahma, Virat, any of those. Vishnu, Shiva, Prajapati, or Bhairava, Bhairala, all of these are manifestations of the same Ishwara. But Ishwara is not limited to any of those forms. Tatha cha uktam panchadashyam. In this Chitradeep, so in the sixth chapter, these ideas are gathered and refuted. Eva manye swasva pakshabhimanena anyathanyatha mantrarthavada kalpadin ashritya pratipedire antaryaminam arabhya stavarante shavadinaha Santyashvatthark Vamshade Kula Devai Kula Daivata Darshana Tattva Nishchaya Kamena Nyaya Gamavicharinam Ekaiva Pratipattisya Sapyatrasputamuchyate.
So here Eva Anne,
various matas are there, they swasva pakshabhi manena anyatha anyatha. In various ways, they explain their own paksha because of association, abhimana with that paksha. This is my paksha. They have an agenda. Therefore, mantrarthavada kalpadin ashritya pratipedri. They explain by taking basis of mantra, arthavada, all this kalpadi, kalpanaitya. They don't hold on to the reality. They have pre-concluded based on something else, which is not pramana really. Antaryami, starting with antaryami, they go with stavaranteshu. Stavaranta ishavadina. Even, you know, pagans, they worship trees, all of these, you know, they worship trees, stones. So the entire range is available. In Sanatana Dharma, we have the entire range available, starting with antaryami and ending with stavara. And then santi ashvattarka vamshadehe kuladevata darshanat. So kuladevata, people consider there is kuladevata ityadi. Tattva nishche kamin, and kuladevata is taken as Ishvara, that is fine. But taking kuladevata only as Ishvara, no one else as Ishvara, refuting others, that is not right. Tattva nishche kamina nyayagama vicharinam. And then use tarka, shushka tarka also, based on nyaya, or then agama shastra, tantra shastra, that will lead to some nishchaya of tattva, which is not valid because there is no shruti basis there. Even if they are based on shruti, they present something for easy understanding. It is not literal. Ekaya pratipattisa sapyatra sputamuchyate. And then what is the reality that pervades all through? That is revealed by the shruti. Then the other... there was another tippana there. Mayastha buddhi vasanayam pratiparita chaitanya pratibimba ishwaraiti. Vidyaranya kruta panchadasya abhihitam. So what is said in panchadashi, that is taken as basis by refuting all other Ishvara matas. Who is Ishvara really? Mayastha buddhi vasanayam pratiphalita chaitanya pratibimba Ishvara. We have seen this in the Mula. Ishvara megha kasha kalpa tulya. Kalpa pratyaya is used for tulyatvam there. Actually, it literally means one less, a little less, but then let's not go into that. Tulya is an easier way to explain. Ishvara is mega kasha tulya, comparable to mega kasha in the example. Ityatra mega sadrishi maya, megastha jalasamanaha buddhivasanaha, tad jalasthakasha pratibimba samaha chidabhasaha, buddhi vasana pratiphalita pratibimba sama Ishvara iti kathane na kopi dosha prasajyate. Therefore, whatever example we have seen all this, who is comparable to whom. So maya is like megha kasha is Ishvara, megastha jala can be compared to buddhi vasana. We have seen in the Mula also, the Jalapurna Ghata was compared with the Kamadi Vasana Purna Buddhi. Taj Jalastha Akasha Pratibimba Samaha Chidabhasa. Chidabhasa is Jalastha Akasha Pratibimba. The Akasha which reflects in the Jala. In Megha as well as Ghata, of course. But then here in the Samashti, Megha Kasha includes the reflection of the Mahakasha in the Jala. Megha gata jala. That is Chidabhasa. Buddhi vasana pratiphalita pratibimba sama Ishvara iti kathane na kopi dosha prasajyate. So if one says buddhi vasana pratiphalita pratibimba sama Ishvara, when we shifted to avidya, before that we had closed that buddhi pratibimbita is buddhi vasana pratiphalita pratibimba sama Ishvara. So if one says, because this buddhi vasanas are comparable to megastha jala samana vasana, therefore reflecting in all the chidabhasas, their buddhi vasana pratiphalita pratibimba sama Ishvara. Ishvara is similar to that, buddhi pratibimba, then there is no dosha. Maya rupa ajnanasyeva ishvaratvapadaka upadhitve api buddhigata vasana ajnane antargata bhavanti. Maya and buddhi, maya and avidya are not different. Therefore, maya rupa ajnanasya, that ajnana, which is same as maya, eva ishvaratvapadaka upadhitve api. If you take that, maya rupa ajnana as upadhi, ishvara upadhi, then buddhigata vasana ajnane antargata bhavanti. Because buddhi has vasanas when they manifest from ajnana, from the karana sharira. Therefore, vyashti and samashti differences are superficial really. You can understand one through the other. This is the mandukya prakriya as well. In mandukya, at each step, when omkara is analyzed, akara, ukara, makara, they are analyzed at vyashti samashti levels both. In Taittiriya also, Taittiriya, when you do pancha kosha viveka, the koshas are to be understood at the individual and the total level. When atma misunderstanding is taken in the kosha, the atma, the annamaya atma becomes annamaya kosha. Then pranamaya becomes atma. That time the virat purusha is also to be refuted, this virat sharira, because it is annamaya kosha. So samashti and vyashti can go together. Sarvajnyatvasya tu karanam ajnana gata sattva guna eva. So sarvajnyatvasya ishvarasya tu karanam ajnana gata sattva guna eva. The differentiation is made by sattva guna or malina sattva. Ayancha sattva guna jnana rupa sakala buddhi nam upadana karanam bhavati. That sattva guna is the upadana karana for all buddhis. Tasmat sushuktau sakala buddhaya sopadana aunshe viliya upadanatmana eva vartante. Therefore, in karanavastha, in sushupti, there is no differentiation between jiva and ishvara or jiva and jiva also. Where raja is no raja, where bhikshuka is no bhikshuka, where makshika is no makshika, vyagra is no vyagra. That kind of non-differentiation is there in sushupti because of sakala buddhaya sopadana aunshe. In their own upadana, they become vilina. Vili upadana atmana eva vartante. Upadana rupena avasthiti eva sukshma samskara ityuchyate. Folding back is called as sukshma samskara. Vasanas are in sukshma form. They manifest as buddhigata vasana when the sukshma sharira is born, when one wakes up to a dream or waking state. Ayam eva samskara vasana ityapi kathyate. So samskara and vasana are interchangeable words. Ittham ajnana gata sattvamshat prithak vasana nama na kachana asti. There is no vasana separate from ajnana sattvamsha. Ajnana gata sattvamshat prithak vasana nama na kachana asti. So sattva guna, which manifests as buddhi, in that there is the seed for all the vasanas, samskaras. Tasmad buddhi vasana shabdena ajnanastha sattvamsha eva graya. The sattvamsha, which is the sattvamsha is the karana. Ayancha sattva guna jnana rupa sakala buddhi nam upadana karanam bhavati. Sattva guna is the upadana karana for all buddhis. Therefore, vasanas are sattva guna. Prithak vasana is not there. So, some explanation is given for non-differentiation using samskara and vasana are interchangeable words, and buddhi vasana shabdena. When you talk about vasana, buddhi vasanas, what is meant is ajnanasya sattvamsha eva grahya. So, this was used earlier to I should have covered it then. I'm just trying to search the point where it was the vasanas were mentioned there. It has gone across pages. Yeah, mayayam. See, Ishvara Swarupa Varnanam and there mayayam, which was mentioned. This maya, mayam pratibimbita chidabhasa. There, the tippana, I think, is this. मायास्त बुद्धि वासनायां प्रतिफलित चैतन्य प्रतिबिंब ईश्वर. सो मायास्त बुद्धि वासना, he wants to talk about buddhi vasanas there, which are there in maya, because maya is samashti and buddhi vasana avidyas, they are vyashti, but then maya at the samashti level includes the vyashti. That's why antaryami or ishvara is a name given to at the samashti level, although the prakriya of mandukya talks about prajna, who is at the vyashti level. So there antaryami is the name given, that antaryami is mayastha, but then they are equated. So that explanation for mayayam pratibimbita ishvara. So that finished the ishvara discussion. We'll look at the 185th avarana, brahma swarupa varnanam, in the next patha. Tomorrow is guru. I think shukra is Prathama Tithi, Pratipada, perhaps. So, I'll see you on Shaniwara. Let me just cross-check. If there is a change, I'll mention. Otherwise, I'll see you on Shaniwara. Sukhanityam Swaprakasham Vyapakam Namurupi Adhishthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddher Drukhetta Nirvana Param Sarvedanta Vidyam Pratyak Paramah Tadeva Amnamattva Nittime Nishitamatihi Tatsat. Any questions? Yeah, Prathama on Friday.